as I walk the hemisphere. Got my wish to...
Sean Penn and Eddie Vedder seem likely artists to cross paths, which they have on several backstage occasions. The voice of Pearl Jam spoke to Sean in such a unique way that when it came time to scoring Into the Wild, it was Eddie that he called upon to do the honors. Sean felt the visuals of the film could only be orchestrated by Vedder, who offered his musical soul.
The decision to ask Eddie Vedder into the mix came out of watching the film unfold as we made it. This, you know, and influenced to no small degree by what Emil started to be to me, what surprises came out of that. There was one voice that kept coming back to me that represented the kind of musical soul of that character that I was shooting every day, and that was Eddie Vedder.
Eddie and Sean shared a similar passion for the great outdoors, whether it was riding the rapids together or sitting by a fire having a cup of coffee. Cherishing their friendship, he couldn't wait for the opportunity to work together, and Sean would be the only person who could tell Chris McCandless's story.
If you read the book, you know, one of the things that comes screaming through is that this young man is probably the last guy that would ever want a movie written, or, you know, made about him, maybe. Or certainly not a commercial feature that was, you know, blown out of proportion and, you know, super romanticized and, you know, something completely out of his control. And so he's very fortunate that you know, somebody like Sean is the one who picked it up, and because he took such great care with it and really came at it with a dignified and galvanized approach.
Into the Wild is the first solo album from Eddie for a movie soundtrack, which includes 9 original songs and 2 covers, and it debuted at number 11 on the Billboard charts, selling 39,000 copies its first week.